authentication message hyphen digest enter. So that means this command area 0 authentication space message hyphen digest, that means in area 0 all the router should enable authentication hyphen message digest, then only it forms the neighbor relationship, otherwise it won't form the neighbor relationship. Just a second, it will downs the neighbor relationship. It will take few seconds to down the neighbor relationship. Do show IP route. Yeah, here we can see. So the neighboring connections, all of them are goes down. Now we can go to the all the router in area 0, R2, R3 and R4 in the router OSPF and particular process ID. Then after that we can go to, after that we can give the command area 0, next authentication message hyphen digest, then only it forms the neighbor relationship. This is another thing for configuring MD5 authentication, but here we cannot use any key. Just we can enable MD5 authentication means in that area all the routers should enable the MD5 authentication, then only it forms the neighbor relationship. Now we can go to the R2 router. So this is in router configuration mode. So here I will give area space 0 authentication message hyphen digest enter do right. I will save this configuration into NVRAM. It will forms the neighbor relationship. Here we can see I got a neighbor relationship from R1 router. So now I can go to the R3 router. So in R3 router also I will go to the router space OSPF and given the process ID as 3. Here I will give area space 0 authentication message hyphen digest do write. Yeah, here also see I got a neighbor relationship with R1 and R2 router. Now I can go to the R4 router. So in R4 router also I will given area space 0 space authentication message hyphen digest do write. It will save the configurations into NVRAM. Now we can go to the R1 router. So first of all here we can see all the neighbor relationship can be goes down. After that I will go to the R2, R3 and R4 router. I will configure area 0 and enable the authentication message digest, then it will forms the neighbor relationship to R2, R3 and R4 router. Let's we can check do show IP space route. Yeah, we can learn a network from outside the area 0. Okay, so now we can ping R6 router to R1 router using the router ID. So ping 1.1.1. Sorry, we cannot ping to the router ID because router ID we cannot assign that IP address to any physical interface or logical interface. So we can just ping this router using the physical interface. So we can go to the R6 router. So ping 200.200.200.200.1. Yeah, we can get. So why R6 router cannot ping to 1.1.1.1? Because in R1 router I will assign the router ID as manually. So if you want to ping that R1 router ID means we can mention this router ID into OSPF network. So then only it will advertise to the neighboring router. So I will assign the router ID manually, but I cannot use this network into OSPF. I cannot use this ID into OSPF network. For example, in R1 router goes to the global mode. In global mode router OSPF 1, next I will mention network 1.1.1 and wildcard mask is 0.0.0.0 space area 0 means it will forms the neighbor relationship. It will advertise this 1.1.1 network into neighboring router, then it will knows this network, then it will ping to the ping to this network, but I will not advertise this network into OSPF. So that's why only R6 router does not know about this network. That's why it cannot ping to this IP address. Okay, in this video tutorial we can see how to configure OSPF routing protocol using MD5 authentication. So normally we can configure OSPF routing protocol means it will forms the neighbor relationship. For security purpose we can use MD5 authentication. So using MD5 authentication, if the both routers should use common same key, then only it forms the neighbor relationship, otherwise it won't form the neighbor relationship. So in this video tutorial we can see how to configure OSPF routing protocol using MD5 authentication. So in OSPF routing protocol we can use MD5 authentication in two types. That means in router configuration mode we can use area and mention the area ID. So we can use the MD5 authentication for common for that area. For example, area 0. Next we can mention authentication message-digest means all the router in that area 0 should enable that MD5 authentication, then only forms the neighbor relationship. This is an one type of MD5 authentication. And another one is we can go to the particular interface and create the MD5 authentication and create the key. And neighboring router also we can create the MD5 authentication and create the key, so that key should be matched on both router, then only it forms the neighbor relationship. So we can use MD5 authentication to form a neighbor relationship. Okay, thank you for watching.